Today, in conversation with the very warm and the very, it's like dashing and the very hot Savio, the celebrity stylist in town today and with me now at the moment. Well, welcome to Kolkata, Savio.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. That was such a nice introduction. I love it. Thank you so much.
Well, so how it's all like for you to place, like being a stylist, like how it's all started, the journey, if you could share in brief about yourself.
Yeah, I started about 22 years back and I've been a hairdresser ever since. My first hair show in my life as a hairdresser happened in 2003, the same year, basically, just a couple of months here and there. Was in Calcutta at the Park Hotel, you know, where I was representing an international brand. So I'm very happy to be over here once again after more than 17, 18 years. So it's exciting. And yeah, I've started off, I worked with Nalini and Yasmin for about 8 years, opened up another 2 salons. And finally, 10 years back, I started off with Savio John Pereira, the salon, that is, which is functional right now in Bombay. And by the end of this year, we plan to open about 11 more salons. So yeah.
So how was the transition like? I just want to know about the transition period from the day one was Savio, and now he is a stylist, a celebrity stylist who styles for Priyanka Chopra, for Kangna, for Shilpa Shetty, Kundra, and many more. I'm sure in his kitty. Well, if you could share a few of the names, like apart from these three, I can cheer for Shilpa. I'm a huge fan of Shilpa Shetty.
Okay. No, because I've worked with a lot of them, so they. Nearly every, I think, Bollywood actress I've worked with, and yeah, it's great because you get good recognition. But the best part is that your hair kind of is, your work is showcased on the big screen, which is nice and exciting. And yeah, a lot of favorites. I love Mary Com. You know, that was like a really big high of doing her hair for her. But yeah, and there are a lot of other women. If I take names, I have to take all the names, so I can't take any names. So if you take the names, it's okay.
Oh,
acha. Mera naam nahi liya.
Acha, well, can you tell me one thing, like in Bollywood, which movie or any such haircut that's really transformed your life from Savio to a celebrity just within a click or just a fraction of a second?
I think it's the first time I did these red highlights for Shilpa, to some blonde highlights for Priyanka, and then Priyanka cut her hair even shorter, and that was a big change. Then there was a singer called Rageshwari, and she had this long hair and she cut it this short, and suddenly everyone was talking about it. And of course, the most important thing was that I was a competition hairdresser and representing India in competitions and winning for India. So the competitions and Bollywood kind of together was a perfect mix, actually. Yeah.
So challenges must be there. So what are those exactly you faced?
Challenges a lot, because one, it was in India, our industry is dominated by women, the women's hairdressing part of it. So either you're a barber or you're a ladies hairdresser. So that was one part. Your sexuality is questioned. You know, yeah. 20 years back, 25 years back, that used to be questioned as well, which is great now. You know, I mean, it just kind of works out so well. People wouldn't take a male hairstylist so seriously doing women's hair, you know. So that part of it has kind of, now the gap is closed, you know, and I think women trust men completely with their hair, of doing a great job and a fabulous job. So it's worked out in those ways, basically.
Yeah. 22 long years in this industry, so you have changed, you have seen the changes, the shifts too much. So what are the changes like, if you have seen so far, apart from this sexual orientations and like the ladies trusting on men or something, like apart from this, what are the changes in professional terms, like if I'm talking about
professional terms? I think people have become a lot more professional. People are training a lot more. The awareness is crazy, thanks to Google and thanks to the internet, you know. So the exposure, people, like in India right now, we are on par with any international company where fashion is, country where fashion is concerned, because we are doing everything that everyone else is doing. So, you know, we are not like far behind or whatever stuff. That's great. We're using the best products in the world right now, you know. So we have access to all that. Earlier to be like, jab tak India aa jayega, it'll be like 2 years or whatever. Today we wanted now. They launch a lot of products before they even launched in other countries, you know, because they get really good market research from how we kind of use products, the diversity that we have. So yeah, it works out well with that part of it.
Common issues generally we face, like so from you, like if you could share the common issues like you generally faced every daily life to cope up with your clients or the celebrities.
I think it's everyone's so ever demanding, you know what I'm saying? So and in a profession like us, you have to be a people pleaser. You have to have a good amount of, what do you call it, hospitality, you know, which kind of works out well, you know. So and you got to be patient, you know, and people, and especially people, see, you don't blame them because there is a look, there is a feel, they are where they are for a certain reason and they expect a certain look. And it's up to us then as professionals and as experts to deliver that part of it. Yeah, so that's a big challenge, you know, the tantrums, all that part of it, yeah.
Any particular trends like you prefer to follow or something like?
You know what the thing has been, if you followed my work over the last 20 years, I've always been ahead of my game, which has been good. So, you know, I've never wanted to do things which the rest are doing. So my interviews, my magazine interviews, and I would like say, oh, you know, now you're going to have big blonde chunky highlights. And other headers would be like, Sav, what are you talking about? And like in 7 or 8 months, I would ensure it became a reality. And of course, having Bollywood actresses, it gave you that great platform of showcasing your work. You know what I'm saying? So it worked out well for me. The gamble worked out. So it's not like, it's not about, yeah, you got to take that chance, right?
Well, I have something, a tricky question for you. It's like, if I ask you which celebrity you would love to like to style up?
Which celebrity I would love to style up? There are lots actually, man. But dude, that's like a very, yeah, it's like a hardcore trick question. If I forget anyone or if I leave out someone, then I'm in trouble. But I think at this point, there's this, there's this singer called Dua Lipa, yeah, so I kind of quite find her very interesting, very enigmatic, and someone who looks very, very experimental, and her music is great, her voice is great, so yeah, it's like someone who I would love to kind of work with. And my all-time favorite is Madhuri Dixit, you know what I'm saying? So I'm planning to give her a new makeover now, so let's see. And the best thing is, why I love Kolkata's, I saw Madhuri all over the place, and I'm like, yes, 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 I love that, yeah.
Which celebrity you really don't want to style up as he or she throws tantrums like hell?
But man, ye to mujhe phasane wala hai.
No, I'm not going to.
No. So there was this popular TV actress, okay, in a very popular soap, you know. So she would drive me mad. You know, she was like, she would just make a fuss unnecessarily. She would trouble my team, trouble my artists who come to kind of assist and all that stuff. She would just make life miserable for everyone. And
what's her name?
It starts with P. P.
Pratyusha?
So that's what, it starts with P. And yeah, very, you know, I had a very famous Bengali actor, Priyanshu
Chatterjee.
Yeah. So he's the first actor he's my first official celebrity actually. Oh. Because his movie was releasing at that time, Tere Bin, Tum Bin, Tum Bin, Tum Bin, Tum Bin, Tum Bin. And I that's all my work in the movie, you know what I'm saying? So it's great. And yeah, so my Bengali and East connections start from there. So Priyanshu, if you're watching, I'm in Cal, bro.
Oh, well, this is now a very funny question I'm going to ask you. If I suggest you to give a change on my hair or something, like I don't look that, right? So, but I want to look that way. So what would you suggest?
For you?
Yeah.
Dude, you're a good looking guy, but you know what? You don't wear your hair properly. You know, you have to. What I would suggest for you is get it. If I had time today, if I wasn't leaving, I would have definitely cut your hair for you. But next time I've got your card with me. Next time I'm in town, I'm going to be styling your hair for you. Oh. And what you should do is, you know what, by default, even if you don't want to style everything, just this front part of it, use a dryer to just dry it out a little.
Okay.
That's it. And you can use a little bit of hairspray or you can use a little bit of gel also, you know, which is perfectly fine. It's not dangerous or anything to use that. That's it. And take it. And again, another look which will look good for you is where you can keep it slightly longish, you know, because you look like a very artistic, very cute, cool. You've got like a multi-layered look about you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. My God, I've never thought of. I do have so much of.
You've got a very interesting face. You know what I'm saying? You have a very interesting face. Like if you look at you, like, oh, he's a very interesting guy. But when you talk to you, you're even more interesting. So, you know, your hair has to be a little bit more playful as well.
Just without going in case, it's nothing more than that. This much I can do. I'm superly excited, elated at the moment.
No, it's superb. I'm telling you. You're such an interesting person, and now you're excited, even more interesting. So you need to keep your hair a little bit more playful. You know what I'm saying? You've got a nice natural wave in your hair. Work around that. Let it grow a little bit. Yeah, you can work around a lot.
Okay, thank you. And the last question is, like, your suggestions for the aspiring stylists.
For the aspiring stylists is, nothing comes without hard work. You've got to work very hard. You've got to practice. You've got to train. You know, nobody ever sees that, you know, or they say, oh, he's a celebrity stylist or he's a this stylist. But we've worked 20 and 30 hour days, you know, slept for 2-3 hours, so worked very hard, and we've practiced, trained all the time, always wanting to learn, you know. With the new generation, I'm sorry, but your guys are a little bit lazy where that is concerned, because you want to enjoy life more, which is fine, to each his own. But if you want to be successful, that's hard work, and you've got to have the right attitude. Have a positive attitude, have the right attitude, be humble, because that's what people want out of us. The hairdressers out there to make people happy.
Thank you, best wishes, and see you soon once again in Kolkata.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you.
For such exclusive videos, do like, share and subscribe, and don't dare to forget to hit the bell button.